Very good morning, my brothers and sisters. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, a great saying goes this way: one who kneels before God can stand any way and before any person. The times that blocks kneeling before God, that is nothing, but it is our unworthiness and sinfulness. Let's call to mind our unworthiness and sinfulness. Ask the Lord for pardon and strength, so to celebrate this Holy Eucharist in worthy manner. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my word, in what I have done and in what I have felt, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask blessed Mary for watching, all the angels and saints and to your mother to pray. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the newness of the nativity in the flesh of your only begotten Son may set us free from ancient servitude, holds us bound beneath the yoke of sin. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Chapter 2, verses 12 to 17. I am writing to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven on account of his name. I am writing to you, fathers, because you know him who is from the beginning. I am writing to you, young people, because you have conquered the evil one. I write to you, children, because you know the Father. I write to you, fathers, because you know him who is from the beginning. I write to you, young people, because you are strong and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the evil one. Do not love the world or the things in the world. The love of the Father is not in those who love the world. For all that is in the world, the desire of the flesh, the desire of the eyes, the pride in riches, comes not from the Father, but from the world. And the world and its desire are passing away. But those who do the will of God live forever. The word of the Lord. Please take on page 636, Psalm 96, verses 7 to 10. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due to his name. Bring an offering and come to his courts. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Tremble before him, all the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is King. The world is firmly established. It shall never be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm has begotten him victory.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verses 36 to 40, page number 59 from the New Testament. There was also a prophet Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage. Then as a widow to the age of 84, she never left the temple, but worshipped there with fasting and prayer, night and day. At that moment she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who are looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord. My brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, As far as the church concerned, that we are still in the octave of Christmas. But as far as the world concerned, we are on holidays because school gives holidays to the children. And children always enjoy these holidays. That they say, we are still on holidays. As a Catholics or Christians, we are in the octave of Christmas. We are rejoicing in the coming of the Lord into this world, into our lives, into our hearts. But today, John the Evangelist in the first reading tells us, do not love the world and the things in the world. That is the very pathetic statement that he gives to all of us. We are still in the octave of Christmas. In the houses, we have not removed our cribs, our Christmas trees. A light still glow. But why John the Evangelist tells us, do not love the world. My dear brothers and sisters, when we are in the world, he is not going to kill our joy in the rejoicing of the Lord. But he tells, be careful in the world. Because when we are in the world is very tricky and it takes you to somewhere different ways. And we also see when we are in the world, when we are in the happiness of the world, it is contrary to the truth. That is why John the Evangelist clearly tells, you come out of that world as a Christian, we need to have a greater change and transformation of our life. Then we see the real truth that God has come down from heaven. That is the marvelous gift that we experience in this world. We can rejoice in the world provided that we change our lives and we also have the transformation of life constantly. That is the way John the Evangelist clearly tells, do not love the world. Whereas they have the change of your lives and transformation of your lives, then you rejoice in the Lord and experience him in our hearts and in our lives. That is why in the second reading, Prophet Anna, she waited to experience the Lord. And she is speaking about the Lord to everyone, those who look for the salvation of the Lord. She experienced on trying to talk to everyone about Jesus, the child Jesus, he is the Savior, he is the Messiah. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, let us see whether we have the change of lives, whether we have the transformation of our lives to rejoice in the Lord. It is the greater gift, that greater grace and love that is from the throne of God that we have received through Jesus Christ. So let us rejoice in the Lord by changing of our lives. Let's pray for this grace, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
This day of hope, we come to you in love, O Lord, of joy. On this day of hope, we come to you in love.
Blessed God of all creation, for through goodness we have this bread to offer, the fruit of the earth, Lord. Spiritual bread.
Yes, O God,
Yeah. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. You destroy the temple, rising, you restore our life, Lord Jesus, come in glory. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and the resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that have held us worthy to be in our presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partake of the body and bread of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who are pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace us, Lord, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grace us, grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on the Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. belly full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Pray for all the departed souls and for this dear Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. As we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
The
Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. O God, who causes us to partake of your sacrament, walk with the effects of its power among us, that we may be made fit to receive your gift through this dedicated itself to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Peace.